hot hits, Joe Dee Messina. You gotta look twice because they're two of a kind, the Lynns. Country music's original Spice Girl, she's one of a kind, Tanya Tucker. And now, your host for our Ladies' Night Out, one of country music's leading ladies, Terri Clark.
All I can tell ya is cry, cry, baby.
This lady is one of my heroes. She first stepped on stage when she was 13 years old. And since then, she's been living at the top of the charts. Tanya Tucker.
It's a little too late. Well, it's a little too late. When you walked in, I should have walked out. But it's a little too late to do the right thing now. Well, the whole town told me you're a heartbreaking. Yes, I ought to pay attention when they say those things. But it's a little too late. Right thing now. Ooh. It's a little too late to do the right thing now. That's right, boy.
We're just starting to cook. It's Ladies' Night at the Wildhorse Saloon with the best in country music. The Lynns, Joe Dee Messina, Tanya Tucker, and Terri Clark. We're back with Terri Clark and Ladies' Night at the Wildhorse Saloon.
We'll turn down, what's that flower you have? Could it be a faded rose from days gone by? And did I hear you say he was meeting you here today? Ooh. To take you to his mansion in the sky.
Woo! Okay, thank you.
Woo! I'm here with Joe Dee Messina, Peggy and Patsy Lynn, and Miss Tanya Tucker. Okay, girls, ladies' night out. Tanya, you've been on the road since you were about this big, you know, an embryo.
Yeah, was a corporal.
And you've been out there a long time, so what kind of advice do you have for us being on the road?
You know, when I first started out, you know, that was, well, there wasn't too many of us. Your mother and, and Tammy and me. And you know, being on the road is really a lot harder for a girl. I mean, it's harder for a woman, period, you know?
Yes.
I mean, for lack of better words. But it's gotten a lot better. But, you know, we used to sign autographs after every show. And I think it's a great thing to do when you're first starting out.
We learn that.
Because people get
important.
Connected with you. I mean, they can touch you and shake hands with you. It really makes a lot of difference.
Well, we sell more t-shirts, too.
Well, that's still...
You know what? It's so strange because you guys... Tanya, Mom, all of the great female artists, the honky-tonk female girl artists, Kitty Wells, they didn't open the doors for us. They kicked them down. And it made it easier. Terri, first time I heard Terri Clark on the radio with Better Things to Do, I thought, oh my gosh, that is some. She listens to Loretta Lynn because of those songs.
Right.
Change my new guitar strings. Where did
strings.
That come
wrote
from?
Strangs.
That's cool.
I co-wrote that with Tom Shapiro and Chris Waters,
and
it was the first song we ever wrote together. And I did listen to a lot of Loretta Lynn.
Listen, nothing. She's been in the dressing room all day long singing One's on the Way.
One needs a hugging and one needs spanking and one's on the way.
Oh, gee, I hope it ain't twins again.
Gee, I hope it ain't twins again.
Now that crossed over, didn't it?
Did it cross over?
No, I don't think
think it crossed over.
Well, it crossed over many boundaries, but I don't know what boundaries that were.
That was
over
the pill.
And over and over.
Don't you think Loretta, though, kind of started all that out? I mean, writing. I mean, she was really one of the first females that wrote.
Mom was one of those that walked up on, she was self-contained. She'd walk up there with her guitar, with her own songs, and just stand up there and just do it.
I think she's also one of the prettiest women in the whole wide world.
Yes, she, I think so, too. You but you know, women today, I notice with country music today, you know, that it's all come back around to where the women in country music today, they're very strong women. I mean, they're going out there, they're playing, they're guitar. I mean,
well, you have to be.
I was watching you on stage on a show that you did, and I was like, huh.
Oh, which one was that?
And the cowbell. Beating the cowbell.
Yeah.
Cowbell,
okay.
But I mean,
look at Jody comes out here and does that little turn in the thing. It's like, you go, girl.
Well, it's just, you know what? It's just really great to see some great female singers. I mean, it's just amazing how many women are in it now. And used to, they wouldn't put girls on the same show together. That was a no-no.
Girls on a record label.
Yeah, and the DJs wouldn't play women back to back. So it's all changed now, and it's fun. You know, girls' night out is fun. I mean, we don't sit around
really
and
bash
the guys, you know. But it's just really great to see some great gals that have great personalities. And, you know, country fans are the best fans in the world. There are no better fans.
Well, you guys have a song you wrote, Woman to Woman, and there's a bit of a story behind this song.
Oh, let's hear it.
Ooh, the smut is out.
Songs that are written by the artist that sings them, I think that's really important, especially because for this song in particular, you had to be there and experience that, I think, to really write it.
And she was there.
And she was there, and there was another woman involved, and she's not there any longer.
They can get my man, they can have him.
Hey, that's the way I feel about it.
Your pardon, girl, but I think it's time we had a talk. You know exactly who I am, yeah, and what I want. You seem to be a bit confused about what's yours and what's mine. So I came in here tonight to show
y'all do it.
I hope that girl's watching. Cool. I hope that girl's watching tonight. I guess she'll get the message.
Yeah.
Well, Jody, we've been friends for a while, right? And I was reading some stuff where you called yourself a survivor and that you've had a rough couple of years. And would you tell us what you're talking about?
Well, Tanya was talking about country fans earlier, and truly there is no more loyal fan in the world, and I learned that lesson pretty much the hard way. In 1996, we had my first album came out. We had Heads Carolina and You're Not in Kansas Anymore, and they came out and did really well.
I love
and
that
then,
song.
Thank you. But what a lot of folks don't realize behind the scenes is it takes a lot of effort and a lot of funding to keep that bus on the road and all those musicians employed. And what had happened was we were waiting to finish my second album, and it wasn't done. We didn't have anything new to send out to radio, and we had been off radio for about a year. When you're off radio, the work slows down and the money stops flowing, and everything that we had, I'd say Christmas time, I remember talking to my manager, Stuart Dill, at Christmas and saying, I don't know if I need to hold on to material things. I think I'm realizing that happiness comes from within, because at Christmas of 1997, we gave back the bus, the house was on the market, and the car was on the market. And we actually spent our Christmas with the children at the Vanderbilt Children's Hospital. And that was the way, you know, we spent our Christmas. In 1996, when Heads Carolina came out, we had a lot of friends, you know, a lot of folks calling up. Everybody was your buddy.
Still, yeah.
And in 1997, when we were off radio, the phone stopped ringing, but one thing that never happened was is the fans never stopped writing, and they never stopped coming to the shows.
Jody, you survived with a great album and a single. It says it all. I'm all right.
Yeah.
Will you do it for us?
Sure.
Cool. So what do you ladies like to do on your ladies' night out?
Watch cowboy butts.
Okay, this one over here is going, my husband's watching, so I can't say that. What do you do?
I'm a big, huge flirt. I have a hard time finding a boyfriend who can deal with it, because I do flirt a lot when I'm out on a date. Do you flirt too?
Yes, I do.
I do. I flirt. See, you don't really talk like that. That was all just.
No,
well,
I do.
Okay. Yes, she does. Well, I'm glad that you like to flirt. I think we all do. I think women are born with the flirting instinct, are we not?
So
it's like. I'm telling you, men will do anything for you if you know how to do that. It's just like. Go get me this, go get me that. I want this, I want a new car. Go get it, go get it, go get it. You got it. What about you?
I'd like to know, of all the ladies, if your best friend were to set you up, would any of you go out on a blind date?
I'm going to sit over here because I gotta get something out of them here. So would you go on, you're married, forget you. Would you go on a blind date?
I don't think I would.
If it was my best friend saying it, setting it up, I probably would. Yeah.
But he would know who you are, so he would have the up
that,
on you. Because everybody knows who you are. It's not like.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
That's probably
that
why
too.
We're all single right now, because everyone's scared of us.
Well, we can fix you up. Single. We know some musicians.
Please fix me. No musicians, right? No singers or musicians. You've never dated a singer, have you?
Tanya.
Oh!
No, but I said I was sworn off of them, but now I'm in love with a writer, singer, guitar picker, so.
Sometimes, because this is what we do, they're the only people that understand, you know.
Well, you know, well,
men are intimidated sometimes.
They
shouldn't be.
You get the successful ones, though. You know, we always get the ones that are just coming up.
That's not
but
true.
You get the,
aren't you married to one?
No, can you? What?
No, pick up your socks. So what's better, looks or money?
Money.
Looks.
Oh, I want one that's rich, old, and got a bad cough.
Well, you know what? It wouldn't hurt to have somebody with both.
I'll tell you what the worst thing about going out with a guy who just does like a normal job for a living or something like that. I was sitting across from this table one guy and he one day and we're eating lunch and I thought I really like him.
He slipped his credit card under the table too.
He just looked at me and he went, I can't believe I'm here with Terri Clark. Well, it's getting late. It's time for me to go.
Can we watch your video again?
Or at least they didn't say, well, you know what? You don't look like you do on TV.
Oh, yeah.
I've had that.
Girl, you're a little plumper than you look on that there video.
You're so photogenic.
I love that one.
Well, you have another song for us. What's it called?
It's called Complicated.
The story of our lives.
The story of my love life.
Continues with Tanya, Jodie, Patsy, Peggy, and Terri, and our Ladies' Night Band. They're hot. Ladies' Night at the Wildhorse Saloon and Terri Clark.
Recording a song is such a personal trip. Sometimes you go through a lot of material to find a song that feels right. Sometimes you pass on a song and someone else makes it a big hit. But that's okay, because I want to do songs that speak to me, and with my album, How I Feel, I tried to open myself up to new roads musically. This song was a departure from some of my previous recordings, and I thank you for taking to it.
Up next, Tanya, Patsy, Peggy, Jody, and Terri go honky-tonk. Welcome back to the best place to be for country entertainment, the Wildhorse Saloon in Nashville, Tennessee.
I think we're all here tonight burning the roadhouse down because some great lady singers cleared the way for us. They went out on the road when it wasn't as easy as it is today. Let's sing a thank you to them.
This is for Brenda Lee,
Gene Shepherd,
Tammy Wynette,
Loretta Lee,
and Patsy Klein.
Kitty Wells, this is the national anthem for Lady Honky Tonkers. I'm
to go wrong.
Recipes for real life.
Numbers and we've caught up on each other's lives. I hope you all take the time to get together with friends that you have and have your own ladies' night out. Thanks for hanging out with me tonight. Let's do it again sometime.
Let's do it again. I'd love it.
TNN, America's country home, is a service.